This all can be said aloud now.
One of the joys of Twin Peaks is that each time through is like watching a different story. Much is left to interpretation, and fans accept that many interpretations are valid. However, creators David Lynch and Mark Frost left a trail of breadcrumbs hidden in plain sight that, when put together like a decoder ring, will change the way you see Twin Peaks inside and out. 18 is such a strange number of episodes for a series. Lynch and Frost said they wrote it like one long movie and then stopped when they were done. But I don't think that's exactly the case. The title, The Return, means more than just our return to Twin Peaks as viewers. It also literally means Agent Cooper's return from the end of the series in 1991 back to the beginning of the series when Laura Palmer was killed. The entire storyline ends with Agent Cooper creating a circuit in time, even if he doesn't know or we don't know where exactly he ended up.
What year is this?
It's well known Lynch never wanted the killer to be unmasked, and was unhappy with the show after he was. ABC had forced the issue, but I'm convinced Lynch and Frost found a way to keep their vision intact, and left a secret hidden in the series for over 25 years. The number 10 is very important in The Return.
I am headed for Sheriff Truman.
It is 253, and that adds up to a 10,
the number of completion.
I believe that the original series is complete after Leland's death, and the final 12 episodes of season 2 split off into an alternate timeline that now exists outside of Lynch and Frost's vision of the series. But the finale contains the biggest clue that unlocks the whole puzzle.
12 rainbow trouts in the bay.
Take a look at that. 12 rainbow trout
is the perfect hidden metaphor to describe these 12 episodes.
There was a fish in the percolator.
The end of the first episode of The Return gives us a nudge in the right direction. The camera zooms in not on human flesh, but on a piece of rainbow trout sushi. Here's the shot from the show, and here's rainbow trout. But there's so much more. Season 2, Episode 10, called Dispute Between Brothers, is the point where Twin Peaks splits in two. Right before the new story arc begins, Cooper says his goodbyes, and he tells Truman what's coming.
Major Briggs says there's a frying pan full of steelhead trout out there. My name on them.
Episode 10 ends with Cooper and Briggs in the woods, night fishing. At the end, Briggs disappears in a flash of light, going elsewhere, and Cooper is left alone and confused. If Briggs departs, episode 10 loses his head and reappears dead without aging in the first episode of The Return, how do we explain his appearance in the finale and the secret history? Besides the rainbow trout, there's something else strange about the finale back in 1991. Right after Wyndham Earle and Annie do a kind of ritual and disappear into the Black Lodge, the next shot, the very next shot, shows Norma, Annie's sister, completely oblivious to the fact that her sister has just been kidnapped. Of course, this doesn't explain Mike's presence or the fact that he and Nadine have their heads bandaged. The last time we saw Nadine, back in episode 10, she's hurling a blonde cheerleader through the air. I'm not saying the story is continuous. I'm not saying that it jumps directly from season 2, episode 10, all the way to season 2, episode 22, with no gap in the story.
Who's Annie?
I'm saying that the two realities are blended together.
That's me.
And one is fading away.
Caroline.
To create a new kind of combination reality, as it was described at the end of the final dossier.
How's Annie?
Perhaps there's a subtle nod to both Briggs and Nadine's split timelines. In retrospect, we were being introduced to the idea of experiencing two different realities at once.
Heisenberg.
Which is one of the fundamental themes of The Return. But we'll talk about quantum physics, Annie, and Firewalk with Me some other time. Let's get to the meat of this. If you lay out all the original episodes of Twin Peaks, without episodes 11 through 21 of season 2, line them up with the 18 episodes of The Return in reverse. When you do this, something magic happens. events scattered throughout their return align perfectly with their doppelgangers in the original series. There are many of them, some thematic, but some are too obvious to be ignored. In Season 2, Episode 6, Pete recognizes the song that Leland is singing in The Great Northern.
The King and I.
In the return Episode 6, Red just suddenly says,
"Did you ever see the movie The King and I?"
The King and I, by the way, or Anne and the King, the book, is a story about a woman who chooses whether or not to accept a kind of ring of power from the King of Siam. Just saying. One of my favorite sinks is when Cooper is shot in Season 1 at the final episode. That would be Season 1, Episode 8, and then he wakes up in Season 2, Episode 1. So at the same place where Cooper is shot in the original series, he manages to avoid being shot in the return because he followed his instincts and had a cherry pie with him at the time.
This cherry pie is a miracle.
In the return Episode 9, Bobby finds the Cooper, Cooper, Cooper message hidden on a piece of paper in a chair in his mother's house. Back in Season 2, Episode 2, Briggs brought that message from space to Cooper.
Cooper.
Also in the return Episode 9, Beverly and Ben are looking for the source of this strange sound they hear. Have you ever listened to the sounds of the universe? In Season 2, Episode 1, Gerson makes her appearance playing the piano for the Palmer family, and in the return Episode 11, Gerson appears for the very first time. One of my favorite scenes in all of Twin Peaks is when Albert confronts Truman in Season 2, Episode 3.
The foundation of such a method is love.
In the parallel scene in the return, that's when Albert meets the coroner, Talbot.
Came out to join you, Diane, while Albert's indisposed.
Frankly, I found so many in the series that I feel like there must be many others hiding throughout. Though there's many more, some I found, and I'm sure plenty that I haven't. My favorite, I've saved it for last, it's Audrey's Dance. That's right, in the return, part 16, and the third episode of the original. There's no doubt in my mind that all this is intentional. In fact, it actually unlocks other secrets hidden in the return. I'll get to that in a minute, but first, after we see Major Briggs disappear from the end of Episode 10, he appears one more time in the series, and that's in the Season 2 finale. We already knew the series is a time loop, but looking at the new relationships between episodes shows new connections.
The Black Lodge with Ian Cooper.
It's a safe assumption that Mrs. Palmer is channeling the experiment here, based on her story arc in The Return, but taking a new look at Season 2, Episode 10 shows a striking visual and thematic symmetry between Mrs. Palmer, Laura, Cooper, and Major Briggs. In fact, these four episodes will now become a kind of roadmap for the entire series, as well as the key to unlocking the true purpose of Cooper's journey as it twists its way through time.
Huh?
Is this future or is this past? That's a good question at this point. Mr. C has clearly meddled with this in some way.
You met with Major Garland Briggs.
How did you know that?
Let's look at one really interesting thing about part one. First, there's a direct nod to the audience to show the connection to episode 22. It's right there on the cups. That stuff just doesn't happen by accident. Part one has many mirrors to episode 22.
The log lady stole my truck.
Something is missing. And you have to find it.
Here's the beginning of episode 22 and the end of the return part 1, respectively. Here's the safety deposit boxes, watched over by a guard in a gray uniform. And a guard in a gray uniform helping to guard SD cards, I guess. Warren is going on about a stinky skunk.
The skunk was on the whole other side of the hotel.
And in episode 22, he's got a pine weasel pin on. The pine weasel and the skunk have mirrored markings. And we've already talked about the rainbow trout.
Mike says you're fishing buddy.
Additionally, there's a whole thing with keys, with Packard, and then also with the woman in the return. Once we've looked at all of the reversals and we've decided, okay, there's a pattern here, what else fits together? Well, obviously you're going to take a look at episode 8. It's unlike any of the other episodes, and there's this feeling that it must mean something. The secret that surrounds episode 8 of The Return is the secret diary of Laura Palmer. The diary comes up in The Return, parts 6 and 7, where Hawk finds the diary, and in season 2, episodes 5, 4, and 3, where the diary is prominent, and it must have been the place where Leland actually hid it in the bathroom of the sheriff's station because he had been locked up for killing Jacques Renault. Not only was the diary the key to unlocking the sad, secret life of Laura Palmer, it actually did something else in our world. It goes much deeper.
You're like the dreamer. Dreams, then lives inside a dream.
Your reaction to this video will help me determine if I should make another one. All of these things form a pattern of something that is so incredible. It has to be seen to be believed. It's not just the pattern of The Return, though it's cool. There is something that is much darker and much bigger lurking beneath the surface. There's more to it. There's a lot more to it.
There's nothing quite like urinating out in the open air. I look forward to hearing more about this White Lodge.
When I return from my journey,